I will introduce the idea of resonance time distributions here. This is an important topic in chemical reactors, and it's important because not all molecules spend the same time in the reactor. This is the thing to keep in mind, and the question is, why is that important? It's important because different resonance times mean different reaction times, and this can significantly affect the product distribution when we have more than one reaction taking place, and almost every system has more than one reaction. So product selectivity, for example, in polymerization reactors, polymer molecular weight distribution can be significantly affected by the resonance time distribution. So we'd like to be able to determine the resonance time distribution for a real reactor, and we can do this experimentally using a tracer technique. So if this represents our reactor, what we do is inject a tracer into the feed side of the reactor. And then we have a detector here. This is a detector. And what it's doing is measuring the concentration of the tracer leaving the reactor. So we inject a tracer at the inlet, what we call time zero. It takes some time for the tracer to move through the reactor. And because different molecules spend different amounts of time in the reactor in general, then some of the tracer is going to show up sooner than other parts of the tracer that was injected because of this resonance time distribution. And the tracer can be a dye, can be a radioactive tracer material, can be an electrolyte, something that's going to have similar properties to the actual feed to the reactor. And so if we do this, what do we expect the behavior to look like at the output? So here's the idea. We inject a tracer. So this inject a tracer looks like very narrow pulse where I'm plotting concentration of the tracer as a function of time. So we inject it in a very short time. And then the outlet, we're going to see something that might look like this. So the outlet detector, we're going to get some tracer that's spread out in time. This is the outlet. And it's spread out in time because different molecules spend different times in the reactor. The area under these curves, so it's proportional to the amount of tracer, which means the area on these two curves should be identical if our tracer did not adsorb on a catalyst, for example, somehow get held up in the system for a much longer time. So I'm going to take this part and blow it up to create the view here. Then if we look at some small time difference, this area, that's delta N, that's where N's the number of moles of the tracer, concentration. This is the total volumetric flow rate through the reactor, and this is the time interval that we picked. The amount that we inject it, we could call that N0. It's going to be the integral of the concentration over time, from time zero to very long time, times the volumetric flow rate. This then is equal to the amount initially injected, and we expect, of course, all of it would leave. So what's important here, this then corresponds to the amount of material that is spent between time t and time t plus dt in the reactor. Of course, we want to normalize this because the properties of the reactor should not depend on how much tracer we use. So delta N divided by the amount injected then is going to give us the fraction of material that's spent the time between t and t plus dt in the reactor. So delta N, volumetric flow rate, the concentration over that interval, delta T, divided by N0. We're going to call this P of T, delta T. And then, of course, what we're interested in is delta T becomes small, becomes a differential. Then we're going to have P of T, dt. And this P of T, then, is our resonance time distribution, also known as the exit age distribution. Namely, we're looking at the exit of the reactor and asking how long the molecule spent in reactor. What's their age in the reactor? And the P of T is related to this concentration that we measure as a function of T, volumetric flow rate times that concentration over the total, 0 to infinity, volumetric flow rate, concentration. So this just becomes the concentration over this integral of concentration with respect to time. So this P P of t dt is the fraction material that has spent the resonance time between t and t plus dt in the reactor. So P of t is this probability the molecule reside in the reactor for time t, which means that molecule will have that much time to react. Of course, the longer molecules spend in the reactor, the more likely they are to have reacted. Now we can calculate these resonance time distributions, these probabilities, for ideal reactors, but we must measure them for real reactors using a tracer method like I just described.